Me is absolutely connected with stories.
With his story.
Me is story and is connected with the surrounding stories, religion and all these things. Yeah. And sometimes I wonder what happened to you, to your brain with this story thinking. You cannot get involved anymore in any story.
Well, no, it's quite apparent here that the story is just that. It's an appearance. It's only appearing as a story. So it has no power anymore. It's just another thing that appears to be happening and is not really. But the brain is only a computer. The brain goes on computing away, regardless of me or not.
Yes, but in another way. I sometimes get involved in the story, and then I get out of it. What was that? It's just illusionary. This change.
No. But me would get involved in the story, because me and the story are both the same thing. Me can only live in the story.
Mm-hmm.
When that collapses, it's quite obvious that the story is like everything else, simply in appearance.
Yeah,
it doesn't have any reality.
Mm. It's just that, well, something, watching it, well, it just happens.
The brain can function within that apparent story. The brain goes on functioning.
Yeah, sure.
By the story, you could say that walking into a restaurant and ordering spaghetti is a story, because there's nobody in it anymore, it's an apparent story. The brain can order spaghetti and then apparently pick up a book and eat it. But all of that is meaningless, because actually nothing's happening. That's the freedom.
Yes.
That's the freedom. So everything that arises is completely new. And that's the, you could say, but there isn't anybody in it. That's the inner loveliness with the freedom of there not being one, because everything is just that, what it is, very simple and ordinary. But the functioning still apparently happens. But now, of course, it has no significance.
And also some ideas.
Yeah.
Stories that it's another way of looking at stories. Just like films, maybe. Films you see watching in the kino or in the TV.
Cinema.
Oh, TV. Yeah, but there isn't something watching a film. This is not the same as something watching a film.
Mm-hmm.
Because then you'd be separate. There'd be something that was separate. But this is what, in a sense, self-inquiry does. It becomes detached. It creates a sort of detachment. So you live in an ivory tower and watch life happening. Forget it. That's just another game that me plays, of being safe. I'm now in my retirement, I'm a bubble. But there's nothing like that. All there is spaghetti. All there is
no sauce.
There's nothing doing. It's very, very ordinary and very natural. So there's nothing you can get hold of here. Don't try and take anything home. Like there is no one or there's nothing you have. Just forget it. You don't need to remember anything. You don't need to hold, you don't need to get anywhere or go anywhere. You can't get this right or wrong. What you long for is what is. You can't escape from what is. That's all there is. When you get up and walk out of here, that's what is. When you put the key in the door, that's what is. When you think about whether this is absolute nonsense or might be acceptable, that's what it is. Mm. But also, what we're trying to point to is, what's being pointed to here, is it's about something very ordinary, like moving your finger, scratching your neck, or yawning, or sitting on a chair. It's not about some colossal abstract notion. What you long for is immediately what is. Immediately.